I would never thought we would be coming back here till the summertime. Till springtime, here we back around Cincy, Wales. Welcome back to Cincy, Wales. We will be welcoming on this CNO&TP from Chattanooga, Tennessee to Cincinnati, Ohio. That's where it began, and that's where it ends. So, we would have our first southbound on a CNO&TP. It'd be 375 from Sharonville, Ohio to Louisville, Kentucky. It would have a single ACC leader and then have a AC6M as a weird GPU. But after that GPU pass, this will be the only train in Crittenden, Kentucky, until we go back to Walton for a few minutes for the southbound. It'll be ending at 179 from Bellevue, Ohio to Chattanooga, Tennessee. So it has an ace leader up front and then a C6M as a new GPU. But after the weird GPU passed, we would ending up meeting with a friend that is a nice whale fanner, that's his channel. But the friend that I had with me in the car while seeing these trains was CSXN's train videos. Here comes 28C head straight north with these old southern signals. What after that 28C went north? We would have 174 from Chattanooga, Tennessee to Elkhart, Indiana. It wouldn't have anything special, but it's still cool to see. Since last time I was in Cincinnati area was probably back in like December. So whatever train I would get, I don't really care. At least I seen some trains. So 174 would split the southern signal. After that other northbound, which is 174, that would head north, we would have a southbound, which is 171, from Conway, Pennsylvania to Chattanooga, Tennessee. But it would also have a C6M as a middle and front. So this one was coming straight south towards Chattanooga. if I would have to take a guess, this one is probably 376 from Louisville, Kentucky to Sternville, Ohio. It's the opposite of 375, but this one is 376. Here comes a southbound after that northbound went by. This southbound is flying, and this one would be ending up 143 from Elkhart, Indiana to Macon, Georgia. It would have two C6Ms and a front lead engine, and then it would have a mid ECU. This will be the last train of the day. We didn't see much on the CNO&TP. This will be ending off our last one for the day. Till we go back to our hotel to check in. So this is 335. It would also head to Louisville. It would have a UP leader to be leading 335 from Cincinnati to Louisville. Just a very well note, this train is actually very short, so no wonder he's flying after that southbound. 2780-2808. That's the power for this local that's sitting here. Welcome back. We're Welfane in Carroll, Ohio. The first train is N560. The power is both AC4400 CWs, and one of them is Line 3, and one is a Line 2, Yellow Nose 2. So, yeah. But anyway, this is N560 from Queensgate Yard, Cincinnati, to Selkirk, New York. Moments after that northbound, which is M560, we would have another northbound on the Toledo. We went over to the other crossing just south of us. We would check, there's another green signal for a northbound. This one is D820. That's heading north on the Toledo, but this one is an ethanol. The power would be just Evos and AC44CW, that was one, and then just two Evos. One is a DC, and a www.csx, the website. Now we are close to Miamisburg, Ohio. This train is on the Dane District. It's a grain train, would be 45R heading south on the Dane District. Thank you. After getting a train on the Dane District, we would have us northbound in the Toledo subdivision. That's why. This one is L-424 that's heading towards Lima in Miamisburg, Ohio. The train that we are waiting for in Miamisburg, just south of Miamisburg, it's L-423, which has an SD-40-2 on it. It's kind of weird that I don't see SD-40s leading on a local road train. This one's going for Lima, and L-423 is heading towards Cincinnati. But this one will be meeting at MC Cabin, just north of Dayton. Just after like 10 to 15 minutes later, we would have another train on the Dane District. This one is 171 from Conway, Pennsylvania to Chattanooga, Tennessee. It would also have a fresh Union Pacific trailing second, while an ace of NS is leading 171. Number CSX-8350, the SD-40-2, will be leading L-423 from Lima, Ohio to Cincinnati Queensgate or Guest Street Yard in Cincinnati, Ohio. This train that we would be waiting for, because not only than that, it would have an SD-40. So that's pretty darn cool. It would be flying south. This would be the last train at this spot, just south of Miamisburg. But anyway, we would go south of Carlisle next for our next spot. We are now south of Carlisle, Ohio. We are now catching I-141, which is from Baltimore, Ohio, to Atlanta, Georgia. It would have a zero up front and then one as a rear. This one we would see before getting B-522, which is a southbound steel coil train to Middletown, Ohio. But anyway, this train will be working Queens Gate Yard. There goes the weird DPU of I-141. This is a GMO, by the way, so I thought I would get this angle of the weird DPU. Anyway, this will be the final train of my trip to Cincinnati area. This is B-522 heading towards Middletown, Ohio on a Toledo sub. It comes from Detroit, Michigan to Middletown, Ohio. This is like a steel train, so it goes to Middletown. Well, anyway, it has like a MAC reading, and then the GMO behind the MAC. This will be our final train for the trip. And I always said that before, but I'm just gonna say that again. But just south of Carlisle, Ohio, we'll be ending up here. Then we'll go to Middletown, Ohio to go eat at Little Rosie's in Middletown, Ohio, which is a pizza place. But unfortunately, Cincinnati will be ending up here. Thanks for watching. I'll be seeing you in the Michigan or St. Or the Buckeye State Wells. The Cincy Wells signs off here in south of Carlisle, Ohio.